Yes, welcome. Let's take a quick look on how to do the inside cornrows. I want today's video, I'd like to dedicate it to everyone who is watching right now. And if you know you love Hair Zipper, if you know you love Moritz the Project Master, we're going to start with the inside cornrows, and this is how we always do it. Yes, this is inside cornrows. And I told you that inside cornrows last longer than the normal cornrows that we have been doing. Yeah, according to my research, mine. You can also try it out and see how it's going to be, because we do all types of cornrows. But according to my research, I've realized that the inside cornrows last longer than the other one. So this video we are going to do it as a team, me with my students. As I'd like to show you how we always make the finishing very nicely. And today's case, you have not been seeing this, and we're going to be doing a fringe spring. Yes, that means it's going to be in a fringe style. So we have started with the puff cornrows, as you can see the way it is doing, the way she's doing it. Yes, and I told you we are going to be doing it together with my students. So if you also like to learn, please join us right now and give us more of your time so that we get to know all this together. I told you one thing, that whenever we are doing something like this, please, if you want to learn, maybe try to see something, and then after you practice, because that one will make it perfect, and it will be very easy for you to do it. So you should always see after you do practice. And those people who like maybe those ones who like to forward the video, which is okay. You'd be in need of, you're in a hurry and you'd like to forward, and maybe you reach at the end. But there are some things that maybe sometimes you need to hear to learn, because those ones will let you know more details about the hairstyle that you are going to do, not just looking at something and then you be like, yeah, this is like this. But if you try to give it time, you will know the type of hair that particular style is supposed to be plaited, and what are supposed to be used. Because sometimes there are those things that I say when I'm doing these videos, and you find the same question someone's asking, so that gives me an idea of, like, maybe people don't listen to what I say, then they just watch and maybe they forward, so but it will be very, very okay sometimes to listen to what I already say. So number one, we're going to talk about the fringe. I know most of you people fear to do fringe. You know, sometimes this one, it's real. Most people fear to do fringe. Other they say they're not good for the cat face. For the cat face shape. And they would say that is good for the dog shape face. But I realize there are two things that we always do some mistakes when doing the fringe. Number one, those fringe, when you're supposed to cut it when the eyebrows are not seen, like you cut it without showing the eyebrows and it's done, and that those ones that the fringe is supposed to stop above the eyebrows. So those two things you should always be careful with them before cutting a fringe. So for me, I would give you an idea, or I would share my techniques that I use. That for me, I just cut the fringe slowly, like coming from down slowly. So when I reach that level when the eyebrows are not seen and I see my fringe is looking nice already, yes, I just leave it there and then. Or maybe you've cut it and you're seeing like it is still the same, you're cutting it and still looking good, you try to reach, you make it come above the eyebrows and it is still the same, and then that's nice. But the problem is some people come to cut the fringe and they just cut anyhow without trying to know about those two things. So it is very, very important, you guys, to know those tricks when it comes to fringe, because as you're going to be seeing here how I'm working with my team, that those the times when they reach at the finishing point when I have to help them, they couldn't make it right. But after they realize how I'm doing it and I try to explain to them, now they are good. Another thing on how we do this spring, you can try to see that the plating is different. Some of them can plate this way, going downwards. But what I don't like about this, sometimes it's not perfect. Like you find the spring is not that straight. Yes. Yeah, but there's that plating when you plate going up, not like down, the way you've been seeing how they're doing it. And I will just try to show you how it's supposed to be. Maybe there you can get an idea on how to do it. And when we're crocheting, we are not locking the hair, we just pass it through like that, you understand? That one makes it easy for the plating. Yes. So now when we're done with that, we're going to hold a puff. Still my students are still doing it well. Yes, we're still doing it well. You can see they're trying to hold a puff, and all of them. So when you're holding this puff, you just have to be very careful, because some other people, when you're rough, you'll find you're making the puff very tight and somebody is not going to feel comfortable and she will end up removing the style. So you should always have to be flexible as you're talking to the client, how she feels when it comes to that, how she's feeling, so that you don't make that point of hurting her in some extent. So and another thing I would say, that make sure that your cornrows are always very straight, because they're neat, because the one that gives it the good look. You can see already how it looks. It is very, very nice when it comes to that. And then we just leave here some hair for the fringe, the way we're going to do it, and then we tie very properly. This style, I would advise, like those people with 4C hair type, weak hair, you can plate it, since it's a style that is going to stay there. No need of styling it, or it's not going to be uncomfortable for you, like the time of sleeping, then you have to hold it or to do anything. So this one is very, very protective in that you have to it is nice in that way. So now I can show you here how I'm doing it, right? Her face is cut a dog face, so it's already making a sense in that even if my lines are above the eyebrows, it will still look nice. So this is how I try to come and I help them while on cutting. So this is how I can keep on doing things with my team, and trust me, it is very, very nice. My name is Maurice, the Crochet Master. Yes, and my personal account is Maurice the Crochet Master on Instagram. You can go and follow me. And those ones who would need to learn more, yes, to see more pictures on how we do our things, you can still follow Hairzipper on Instagram, Hairzipper on Twitter, Hairzipper on Facebook, so that you can see all these pictures for the hair cells. And still I upload some other videos that may be detailed on the, my Facebook. But still, if you want to be my friend, please meet me on my account, that is Maurice the Crochet Master. For now, let me sign out and I see you next time. This is my friend, and enjoy it. Bye bye.